what they would say in the entertainment world. Well, we shall, and we indeed will, because you perhaps wouldn't assume that city centres and wildlife photography always go hand in hand. But a wildlife photographer from Leeds has proven that you can take incredible photos in unlikely places. James Kearsley has been nominated for a Bird Photographer of the Year award and was among a handful to be chosen out of 60,000 entries. Not bad, considering it's the first time he's entered a photography competition. Let's find out a bit more from the man behind the lens. Morning, James.
Morning, mate. You all right?
I'm all right, thank you. So tell me about this photograph then. Just obviously it's radio.
Yeah.
Describe it to us.
It was literally just before the first lockdown last year. I'd heard a few rumours online that there was a couple of nesting birds in Leeds City Centre. So I thought I'd go and check it out myself. And there's a small crowd looking at this traffic light. And I couldn't believe it when I got there. There was just a couple of missile thrushes and about three or four chicks sat inside the amber light in the traffic light. So I stood for about half an hour or so, just taking a few photos. And the actual picture that I've entered myself, I was just trying to wait for the amber light to come on so it did the nice orange glow. And I never really thought much of it until this competition come around. And then my girlfriend suggested that I enter it, and I can't believe how well it's done, to be fair.
Is it one of those things, I mean, you can't stage that, you've got no chance. You must have thought, goodness me, what I do and what I enjoy doing, this is absolute gold dust. Did you know at the time?
I knew it was very different to a lot of the wildlife photos you get out there, because obviously it's a mixture of like urban and wildlife coming together in the city centre. So I was really happy with the images at the time. But I never once thought that it'd get shortlisted in such a big, prestigious competition like this one.
This family of missile thrushes got a bit of a cult following at the time as well, didn't they?
Yeah, there was quite a few people going to see them, yeah. People like not even interested in photography really, just because it was so odd to see really.
I've been looking at your photo in the Yorkshire Evening Post online actually when yeah. I knew we were talking to you. This is the kind of, and it's a horrible word, quirky thing that could actually, because you are an amateur photographer at the moment, is this something that could almost rocket you on into maybe doing this a little bit more as something that might earn you some money in the future?
Oh, I'd absolutely love it to. I mean, I do sort of like my own calendars each year and stuff and sell those. But apart from that, I don't really make any money from it. So if it did, then obviously I'd love that to happen.
Is it always birds, James, or is it any wildlife?
Wildlife in general, really. Anything. Deers, seals and stuff like that. I'll photograph any wildlife, really.
What would you say most photogenic of the animals or birds? Who play up for the camera the best?
Probably just the common stuff like robins and stuff. The stuff I really like photographing, like owls and kingfishers and stuff, they're the ones that are just really hard to get photos of, really.
When do you find out how you've done?
From what I've been made aware, it should be sometime later on in the year. It said sort of like August, September time. So it's a long waiting game until I actually find out.
And are you out doing your photography this weekend, today? Are you going to, what sort of, the good to be photographed at this time of year? Is there anything in particular you can hunt out?
Well, it's coming towards sort of breeding season soon, so a lot of the birds are sort of active at the moment. So yesterday I was out walking looking for barn owls and I saw three of those, so we're out photographing them yesterday afternoon. But I think this weekend I'll just be going out photographing deer.
Very good, and good luck with it. Yeah, thank you for talking to us this morning. As I say, if you pick up a copy of the Yorkshire Evening Post, you'll be able to see the photo that James took just outside the Leeds University building of that missile thrush family in the traffic lights. It's a good photo, very good photo. Well worthy of making it through to the final there. Well done to James Kearsley, and good luck to him as well. It's BBC Radio Leeds.